أهلا وسهلا بكم أعزائنا الطلاب في درس جديد من دروس الفيزياء الممتعة Chapter 9 Electromagnetic Induction and Faraday's Law. Our learning objectives for today is Explain Faraday's Law of Induction, Apply Faraday's Law of Induction, and solve the problems related to the topic. In Faraday's experiment, we saw that Faraday's law, as the magnet moves toward the wire loop, the magnetic field increases and the changing flux enclosed by the coil induced an EMF in the coil. That causes current to flow. The amount of the EMF is equal to the rate of the change of the magnetic flux through the wire loop. Let's take a quick revision about the magnetic flux on a surface phi b. Surface is tilted from a face on orientation by angle phi. So, the angle between magnetic field B and cross-sectional area A is phi. The magnetic flux phi b equal B dot A. It will be equal BA cosine phi. And as you know, the SI unit for phi B is Weber. And 1 Weber equal 1 Tesla meter square. As we know from Faraday's law of induction, delta V induced direct proportional with delta phi over delta t, and delta V induced direct proportional with the number of loops. So, combining these relationships, delta V induced direct proportional with n d phi over dt. The units of the SI system combine in such a way that the constant of the proportionality is 1. Delta V induced is equal to minus n d phi over dt. And the expression to the right of the minus sign is just the rate of change of magnetic flux. And by substituting the magnetic flux value, delta V induced will be equal minus n d phi over dt. It will be equal minus n d A B cosine phi over dt, where delta V induced is the electromotive force induced by the unit volt. N is the number of turns on the coil. Delta phi is the change in the magnetic flux through each turn of the coil, and delta t is the time taken for the flux change by the unit second, and negative sign mentions Lenz's law. And from the previous equation, delta V induced is equal to minus n d A B cosine phi over dt. All questions here in the exam, final exam, or on the textbook, you will find the change focus in area or magnetic field or the angle between the area and magnetic field. So minus n a cosine phi dB over dt if b is a function of t plus b cosine phi dA over dt if a is a function change according to the time plus AB d cosine phi over dt if phi is a function of dt and equal to minus n a cosine phi dB over dt minus n b cosine phi dA over dt plus n AB sine phi. The first problem for today. A power supply is connected to loop 1 and an ammeter as shown in the figure. Loop 2 is closed to loop 1 and is connected to voltmeter. A graph of the current I through loop 1 as a function of time t is also shown in the figure. Which graph best describes the induced potential difference delta V induced in loop 2 as a function of time t? We find according to current time graph, the right answer is graph number 1. Problem number 2. A magnetic field of 0.025 Tesla is passing through an ideal solenoid. Then the magnetic field increased with time according to the equation B as a function of time equal B null times 1 plus 2.4 T square. If a circular coil of radius 3.4 centimeter with number of coil number of turns 200 winding is located inside the solenoid with its normal vector parallel to the magnetic field. What is the induced potential difference in the coil at t equal 2.0 second? To answer this question, we should determine firstly the given and we'll find B null equal 0.025 Tesla, N equal 200 turns, phi equal 0 degree, t equal 2 seconds, and the radius is 0.034 meters. And we can calculate the cross-sectional area from the radius and cross-section area times number of turns. We will have n times a is equal to n by r square, and n times a equal 200 by times 0.034 square equal 0.73 meter square. And by using the equation for Faraday's law, delta V induced equal minus n delta phi over delta t equal minus n a cosine phi dB over dt. And B as a function of time is B times 1 plus 2.4 t square. And by substituting n times a equals 0.73 times 0.025 times cosine 0 times 4.8 times 2.0, it will be equal minus 0.18 volts. Problem number 3. The plane of the circular loop shown in the figure is perpendicular to magnetic field with magnitude B equal 0.5 Tesla. The magnetic field goes to zero at a constant rate 0.25 seconds. The induced voltage in the loop is 1.24 volt during the time. What is the radius of the loop? He asks here about the radius of the loop. To solve this problem, we determine firstly the given and non-given. The initial magnetic field is equal to 0.500 Tesla. Number of loops equal 1, and the angle equal 0. Delta T is equal to 0.25 seconds, and B final is 0 Tesla, and the electromotive force is equal to 1.24 volts, and he asked about the radius. By using the formula for Faraday's law of induction, delta V induced is equal to minus Na cosine phi, B final minus B initial over delta T. And by substituting, delta V induced is equal to 1.24 is equal to minus 1 times pi r square cosine 0 times 0 minus 0.500 over 0.250. And by calculating the right hand side, then 1.24 is equal to 2 pi r square. And by taking the square root, r will be equal 0.444 meters. Problem number 4. A conducting ring is moving from left to right through a uniform magnetic field, as shown in the figure. In which regions is there an induced current in the ring? A. Regions B and D. B. Regions B, C and D. C. Region C. D. Regions A through E. What's the right answer? According to Faraday's law of induction, the right answer will be region B and D, because in region B and D there is a change in magnetic field, but in region A, C and E there is no change in magnetic field, and so region B and D there is induced current. Thank you very much and have a nice time. Goodbye.